you for joining us. You're watching the news from Bahrain Television. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received today Al Safriya Palace the representative of His Majesty the King for Charity Works and Youth Affairs, President of the Supreme Council of Youth and Sports, and Chairman of Board of Trustees of the Royal Charity Organization, the RCO, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa. His Highness Sheikh Nasser introduced to His Majesty the participants of the 7th Annual Conference for Effective Partnerships and Information Sharing for Better Humanitarian Action, which was concluded today. The conference was held under the patronage of His Majesty the King by the RCO in cooperation with the United Nations Office for Coordination of Humanitarian Action, the OCHA, and the Organization of Islamic Cooperation Humanitarian Funds, the OICHF, with the participation of 250 individuals from global humanitarian organizations. The United Nations Under Secretary General for Humanitarian Affairs and Emergency Relief Coordinator, Stephen O'Brien, was present at the meeting. His Highness Sheikh Nasser then delivered a speech.
إذا سمحت جات الملك اسمي باسم الإخوان والحضور الجميع نتشرف الله يطول عمرك بالسلام عليكم وبمقابلتكم في هذا المكان العامر. الحقيقة طال عمرك كجميع أعضاء المؤسسة الخيرية نتشرف ومملكة البحرين ككل تتشرف بدعوة هؤلاء الخبرات ووجوه الخير
الحمد لله.
للقيام والتفكير والعمل سويا تجاه الخير وتفعيل دور الخير والعطاء لكل من هو محتاج من الدول القادرة على المساعدة. والله الحمد يا جلالة الملك أن احنا توصلنا في نهاية هذه اللقاءات والمؤتمر إلى حلول وأفكار جديدة في فعالية الأدوار وسرعة الإيصال المساعدات والطرق الجديدة المتبعة. لا الحمد طويل العمر هالرجال خير من يمثل بلادهم وأتمنى من السيد أوبراين أنه يلقي بعض من الإيجاز البسيط بعد المؤتمر لكم صاحب الجلالة وهو رئيس منظمة الأوتشا في اليو أن.
Well, Your Majesty, thank you very much indeed for welcoming us so warmly with this very large delegation, and we are delighted to have this opportunity. First of all, to thank Your Majesty, most sincerely for your kind patronage of the 7th Conference on Effective Humanitarian Partnership and the immense hospitality that you have offered to all participants. So thank you on behalf of us all. And I do bring my Secretary General's personal greetings to you from New York, and he very much looks forward to the next time you have the opportunity to meet him. For me, it is a personal pleasure. It is my first time back in Bahrain since 1977, when I was a very young man, and I had the honor and the privilege to meet the Emir, your father.
Exactly.
And I treasure that memory, and I pay tribute to his memory. And as I have explained to others, I had the opportunity to gain my first ever work experience here in Bahrain, working for Farouk Al-Moyad, with whom I had dinner last night, which was a very nice reminder. I'm also very grateful to your ambassador in New York, the permanent representative, Ambassador Jamal,
yes,
who has helped facilitate so carefully. And I also, at a personal level, bring greetings from my own father, who was responsible for the building of the Riffa Military Hospital back in 1975 and 1976. And I spoke to him last night, and he wished to convey greetings.
Thank you.
It is an opportunity for us to, in thanking you for your hospitality, to thank Kuwait, who have hosted this conference for the five previous times, and now Bahrain has been able to take on the responsibility and the hospitality with such enormous credit, and we are very grateful to you for taking on that mantle. It has been a very wonderful partnership with the Royal Charity Organization,
yes,
for which I know we can hold your responsibility so warmly for that.
Thank you.
In combination with my own office, OCHA, the Office for the Coordination of Humanitarian Affairs, at the United Nations, and with the OIC humanitarian function, which is represented very warmly here by a number in the delegation. And so together we have been able to bring off a very successful event in which Bahrain can take an enormous amount of pride. We have had a high level of attendance, and including, I'm very pleased to say, His Highness yesterday being able to commenced the proceedings with such grace.
Yes.
Yesterday. We were very pleased to have that, the strength of that endorsement. And the topics we discussed were the World Humanitarian Summit, which took place earlier in May,
yes,
in Istanbul, youth and women, two of the very big priorities which I know you and your government and the people of Bahrain give, and thirdly was faith-based giving. We've had 250 to 300 people attending this conference, so extraordinarily well attended, of very key, significant and influential figures in the humanitarian field. So for me, it's been a very important opportunity to engage with so many who are represented here, yes, today. And I think in particular, we have been able to focus upon making sure that Bahrain, not least, who are very much a strong participant in the World Humanitarian Summit, that was not just a talk shop, that we actually made sure that those who made commitments are now beginning to step up, and the process by which they can step up to those commitments to show good example to the world in humanitarian affairs for the people who need us most and who have the least and are suddenly thrust into crisis. And so I'm very pleased that in addition to the series of meetings, we've had this opportunity to have a network, and a lot of what I'm told the current term is like a coffee shop approach, or confi shop approach, where a lot of connections have been made by very significant people and under your patronage, and that's resulted in a series of actionable points which people are going to be able to take away within a year. And those are going to be partnership agreements amongst the participating organizations, making sure more people are aware of the opportunities we have in this very complex world of ever more difficult times, nonetheless, to raise the awareness of humanitarian, both in action, but also the opportunity we have,
yes,
to deliver for the people who need us most, and to exchange best practices, because it's all done with public and philanthropic money, and we need to make those very precious resources extend to, yes, the fullest possible extent. Because it so happens that Bahrain along with your neighboring Gulf states, live now in a region which is both very challenged and at the same time has new opportunities, but also has the world's attention upon it. And so together this conference is giving us a real opportunity to give us a new platform to forge the partnerships which will serve us well. So that's the summary of what we've been up to. And as I say, we've thoroughly enjoyed the hospitality, which has been exemplary, if I may say so. Thank you so much.
And we'll come back.
After that, Royal Charter Organization Secretary General Dr. Mustafa Sayed delivered a speech in which he thanked His Majesty the King for his charitable and humanitarian work. He also thanked all the organizers for the success of the 7th annual conference for effective partnerships and information sharing for better humanitarian action held under the patronage of His Majesty the King. Upon the directives of His Majesty the King, Dr. Sayed went to Jordan and to Syrian border to offer help and made an agreement to buy aid supplies to refugees. He expressed thanks and appreciation to His Majesty the King for fulfilling the refugees' dream of getting education in several countries.
على ما قاله دينامو العمل الخيري واللي عمل الخير في قلبه مثل ما وضحت لي طول العمر على سمو الشيخ ناصر ولا على كلام سيد أوبراين عن نجاح المؤتمر اللي كان فعلا مميز بتعاون الجميع. نشكر كل المنظمين طبعا على راسهم رعايتك الكريمة للمؤتمر. عدد المشاركين أكثر متوقع، أوراق العمل أكثر من الرسمي، كانوا جايين ناس بأوراق بحقائبهم ودهم يساهمون، واجتماعات الجانبية مثل ما تفضل سيد أوبراين وتشجيع من الجميع اللي أمامك طول العمر، كل واحد تحته ملايين من الناس اللي يساعدهم ويدعمهم، كلهم مؤسسات كبيرة وجبارة، إن نجمعهم على أرض الخير هذا شيء رائع. بس إلا أريد أقول شيء، طال عمرك قبل 5 سنوات يوم بدأت أزمة سورية طلبتوا مني أن أروح إلى الأردن والحدود السورية لتقديم المساعدة، ورحت يوم الاثنين رجعت 3 قلت عملت اتفاق تنذكرت الشيخ أحمد لشراء مواد $1,000,000 للاجئين اللي كانوا يتدفقون أنا موجود على الحدود. يوم جيت قلت لا، الأردنيين كرماء ما راح ينقصهم أكل بس أبغي مدارس. فحاولنا نقنعك أن المحل مو للمدارس على الحدود وفي البر، فأصريت رجعت يوم الخميس وأردت أعلن يوم الأحد في البرلمان. كان عندنا 48 ساعة، أيمن المفلح موجود، اجتمعنا مع وزير التربية الأردني مع اليونسيف مع المقاول في 48 ساعة حسب توجيهات والموافقات الهاتفية مع سمو الشيخ ناصر. في 48 ساعة وقعنا الاتفاقية وبنينا 4 مدارس تحتضن الآن 9,000 طالب في 21 يوم، رقم قياسي بأي درجة. لا يمكن أن ننفذ هاي الشيء لولا رؤيتكم الحكيمة القوية. إلا الآن شفنا نتائجها، وملاك اللي راح تتكلم قصة نجاح وهي تمثل آلاف الطلاب والطالبات اللي نجحوا في مدارسكم في الأردن يدل على نظرتكم البعيدة. فأنا أعتذر لو أنا كان رأيي غير صحيح في البداية، بس مقتنع أن لازم دائما نتبع كلام البوس and your idea was a stroke of genius مثل ما يقول ستيفن أوبراين. Thank you sir.
مرحبا سيدي الملك.
Representing thousands of school children from the schools built by the Kingdom of Bahrain for refugees in the El Zaatari camp in Jordan, Malak Farouk Ashouli told the story of success. Malak, who is a 10th grade Syrian refugee, expressed gratitude for the Bahraini funded school that she said rescued all the children who lost all hope of success in the future due to the lack of education.
أشرقت المدرسة البحرينية في مخيم الزعتري، فكانت أشبه بحلم أو رحلة لاكتشاف الذات بالنسبة للكثير من الشباب والأطفال الذين فقدوا الأمل بالوصول إلى شاطئ الأمان من خلال العلم والتعليم. فكانت هذه المدرسة بمثابة السفينة التي تجاوزنا بها مرحلة الخلل في التعليم.
احنا شاكرين لحضوركم معنا.
Then His Majesty the King delivered the following speech.
بل احنا اللي حاضرين معاكم الحقيقة في البحرين. انتوا اهل واصدقاء وربع، وقمتوا بأكثر الحقيقة من اللي طلب منكم، وهذا نتيجة ضمائركم الحقيقة الحية ومشاعركم اتجاه إخوانكم وبناتكم وأبنائكم في مختلف أصقاع المنطقة والعالم. فيعني تجمعكم والاتفاق على برنامج يؤدي إلى النجاح في موضوع التعاون وإيصال الأمور إلى المكان اللي يجب أن تصل إليه، هذا من أهم الأهداف. فشكرا على الحضور وعلى تداولكم لأمور الخير والنظرة الإنسانية. نشكر هيئة الأمم كذلك والأمين العام ورئيس المنظمة على يعني حضوره ومساهمته وصبره وجلده على هذا العمل. الإنسان متابعته للأمور الاعتيادية في مكانه فيها نوع من التعب والصبر، فكيف العمل في مناطق فيها الوعر وفيها البعد وفيها التعب؟ لكن سبحان الله الأمور هذه تعطي الإنسان دافع أن يعمل. الأخ مصطفى السيد ما يقصر، وين ما يجيه الأمر يتوجه، وأحياناً ترى هو ما يجيه أمر، هو اللي يطلب وهو اللي يتطوع إلى هذا العمل ويروح. راح مناطق كثيرة الحقيقة وزار مناطق كثيرة وساهم مساهمات بأفكاره وبعمله كثيرة. على كل حال أهم شيء وهو مبتسم، فهذه البسمة هي قوة الحقيقة لكل من يريد العمل في هذا المجال، لأن المناظر والمواقف والحالات اللي يشوفها الإنسان ما هي بسيطة، فيتطلب منه الحقيقة أن يتقبل هذه الأمور بنفس طيبة وبشعور طيب. وطبعا هو لما يكون هدفه ونيته إنسانية فلا شك بيكون سعيد أنه يقوم بهذا العمل. يعني ما لنا هدف آخر، لا هي دعاية ولا هي تجارة ولا هي أي شيء آخر، بل هي خدمة لله ول أبنائنا والبناتنا اللي يعزون علينا. على كل حال واليوم العالم أصبح يقال قرية متقارب بالاتصالات والمواصلات، فاللي يحدث في أقاصي العالم كأنه حادث عندك. نسمع عن حوادث ومشاكل تحدث مثلا في آخر العالم، نتألم من حدوث لأن سمعنا عنها وشفناها. وطالما أن الله مرهي على الإنسان أنه يقوم ويساهم فليش لا يساهم، هذا أجرها عظيم عند رب العالمين. وهي كذلك فرصة زيارتكم للبحرين لكم تطلعون على أمور بلدكم، وإذا عندكم وقت تتعرفون على المنجزات. فالمنجزات منجزات أهل البحرين يعني في كل مجال ما هي بسيطة، منجزات تدل على أعلى مستوى ممكن أن يكون في أي دولة متحضرة. والأساس والسبب هو التعليم. فلذلك لما أخ مصطفى تكلم عن التعليم وعطينا أولوية بالنسبة للمخيمات فهو لأنه الأساس في الواقع في كل شيء. فالبحرين اليوم يعني احنا نفخر بأن 63% من النساء في البحرين خريجات جامعة، 63%، والباقي ترى دارسين، يعني مو بأنهم مدارسين، ويمكن بعضهم بعد شهاداتهم اللي من الحياة أعلى من الجامعة. وتشكل النساء يمكن 53% من موظفين الدولة الحكومة، 53%، وهذا شيء جيد الحقيقة. ما أعتقد في دولة في العالم وصلت هذه النسبة، ما أظن. وفي القطاع الخاص العمال التجارة تشكل 40% المرة تعمل لابس الأوفرهول، تشتغل مع الناس وماشي. فهذا مجتمع متطور جدا، وأكبر دليل على تطوره إن نوضع هدف للمغرضين، لأن المغرض ما أعتقد بيستهدف دولة فاشلة، وهو يريد يفشل الدول. فلما يستهدف الدول الناجحة هذا أكبر دليل إن هي ناجحة. إنجازات أهل البحرين بقوانينهم وبإدارتهم لشؤونهم وباتصالهم، ولكن من بعد الله الفضل لكم، لكم أنتوا كأصدقاء كأخوة كدول بعد تعين. لكن الزين في الأمر أن الشيء القليل يبين في البحرين، فإذا دعمت دعم معين في أي اتجاه سواء تجاري أو اقتصادي من الأشقاء أو غيره، وسلم في الأيادي الأمينة الموجودة، تطور الدعم إلى شيء مفيد على الأرض. وهذا اللي يحدث في البحرين، يعني هذا يعني ما يضيع الشيء مع السيل، لا يثبت. الأساس مرة أخرى هو التعليم. وأنا أعتقد مرة أخرى عن المرأة، المرأة في الانتخابات هي أكبر كتلة انتخابية في كل الانتخابات اللي مرينا فيها. طبعا ما كثير من النساء انتخبوا، لكن اللي انتخبوا أكثر عدد نساء، يعني أعتقد 57%، 57% من الكتلة الانتخابية نساء. والكتلة الانتخابية اللي في البحرين هي أكبر كتلة انتخابية في المنطقة بما في إيران كنسبة. فيعني شو تسوي دولة ما تريد النجاح للبحرين إلا أنها تحاول توقف النمو والتطور اللي حادث؟ مثلا البطالة 3 شوي، يعني فاصل شوي في المئة، يعني هذا هي ما موجود، يعني في 3 هذا الموجود من بطالة، واللي عاطلين عن العمل أو بعد فيه لهم رواتب. لكن الحمد لله لما صار هذا البرنامج ما زاد العاطلين عن العمل بسبب الرواتب اللي ضد البطالة. والنمو الاقتصادي اليوم من جهد الناس وليس، يعني يمكن 4-5%، في أمريكا يحاولون 0.5% يزيدون أو 1%. هذا النمو الاقتصادي، هذا مو بشغل حكومة، هذا كله مجتمع، شراكة مجتمعية كلها اللي تتكلمون عنها، الشراكة المجتمعية ليست إنسانية فقط ولكنها العمل أساسا. إذا ردت على التكافل والمحبة والاحترام وذي. العرب والله حتى أفقر الناس عندهم مبادئ وقيم أكبر من كل اللي يقولونه في العالم، لكن الشراكة في الخير، الشراكة في النمو، الشراكة في التطور، هذا اللي صاير اليوم عندنا. والحمد لله الجميع توفق، لأن الجميع مدعوين للمشاركة وليس مجموعة معينة، الكل، يعني الرجل والمرأة والشاب والشابة والبحرين، التعايش اللي فيها والتسامح اللي فيها مشهود له يعني من مئات السنين في الواقع، يعني مو بتو اليوم، مو في وقتنا، من قبل، لأنه البحرين يعني كانت تسمى ميناء العالم، هي كانت تربط ما بين حضارة الرافدين والسند، ويسمونها دلمن، والسفن والعالم والحضارات كلها تمر على هالموانئ، واللي يعجب المقام يجلس. ففي الواقع يعني المهاجرين وهذا من أسباب النجاح ولله الحمد، الهجرة مو من البحرين للخارج، الهجرة من الخارج للبحرين، يعني هذا اللي يحدث اليوم. فيمكن أنتم لاحظتوا هذا الشيء كونكم مسؤولين عن لاجئين، البحريني يحب بلاده، والأجنبي اللي يعيش بين البحرين البحرينيين بعد يحبهم ويحب البحرين. فاليوم عندنا يعني، وفي الخليج يعني، اللي يدلك أن نسبة اللي هاجروا والأجانب في دول الخليج أكثر من الشعب نفسه، هذا دليل أنهم حابين المستوى الدولي اللي وصلت له منطقة الخليج. كيف لا تستهدف والناس في مشاكل؟ الله إن شاء الله يصلح الأمور. الموضوع على كل حال، أنا أعتقد كخلاصة أن العمل الطيب والحسن هو اللي يهزم الشر ويهزم الأعمال السيئة الأخرى، وأحسن عمل ممكن يكون هو كل واحد منا يقوم بواجب اتجاه أخوه والإنسان اللي معاه في الخير ويصبر. وإذا توفقنا في هذه أعتقد إحنا موفقين في أشياء مهمة جدا. فشكرا مرة أخرى. And thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Arrival
and my regards.
His Royal Highness Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa inaugurated today the Invest in Bahrain 2016 Forum in its 11th edition, organized by the Ministry of Industry and Commerce in the Bahrain International Exhibition and Convention Center under the patronage of His Royal Highness the Premier. The Prime Minister encouraged investing in new and promising sectors in Bahrain that ensure large areas of growth and invited investors to utilize the dynamic economy and investment incentives the Kingdom has to offer, as well as the regulations that protect their rights in the search for new opportunities within the facilities offered by the government. His Royal Highness noted the importance of the conference in promoting investment opportunities, products and services for investors, as well as highlighting multiple investment prospects in the Kingdom. He said that the Bahraini economy is based on robust rules that are able to overcome many of the challenges and economic fluctuations experienced by the region and the world, and that regulations must be constantly worked on to reinforce its ability to ensure the continuity of economic growth. His Royal Highness noted the important role of the Bahraini investments in supporting the government's efforts and its endeavors in the field of sustainable development and confirming the government's care in providing elements of a modern investment environment and the provision of facilities that encourage investors to enter the Bahraini market. He also noted that the Kingdom, through investment sites it established, has provided many encouragements in the field of industrial and commercial investment in order to attract foreign capital investments. The Prime Minister pointed that the government's vision is based on continual investment upgrade in the Kingdom, especially through developing the legal system to keep up with the global economic and financial changes and developments, and work to facilitate and simplify procedures necessary for the start of the businesses and establishing companies. He also noted that the Kingdom witnesses launches of projects that develop infrastructure on what has been achieved in terms of logistics and other governmental encouragements that increase the Kingdom's ability in attracting investments. The Prime Minister thanked all organizers of the forum and wished them success in building more successful investment companies between businessmen. The Minister of Industry, Commerce and Tourism, Zayed bin Rashid Al-Zayani, expressed his gratitude to His Royal Highness's patronage of all activities and programs of the forum, which aimed to display the Kingdom positively and to strengthen its economic and development march that is based on the strategies and wise vision of the leadership and the government. Al-Zayani affirmed his gratitude as this event aims to fulfill an aspect of His Royal Highness's vision to achieve sustainable development for the Kingdom of Bahrain through diversifying sources of income and the promotion of investment advantages of all sectors. He also noted that these steps are in sync with the successful economic policies and the steady expansion approach of the Kingdom under the guidance of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa and the keenness of His Royal Highness the Prime Minister, as well as the support and supervision of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander, First Deputy Premier Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa. Al-Zayani stated that the achievements realized and the efforts exerted are for achieving the best interest for the Kingdom, in which it will allow the provision of high living standards for the people of Bahrain. He also added that the Kingdom of Bahrain is considered the only country in the region that grants foreign capital full possession of assets and real estate in most sectors, in addition to organizational efficiency and financial freedom that elevated the Kingdom to hold first place on the region and Gulf levels and the 18th place internationally, according to the Index of the Economic Freedom of 2016 issued by the Heritage International Foundation. The chairman of Eastern Region's Chamber, Vice President of the GCC Chambers Federation, Abdurrahman Al-Ataishan, lauded this event and the investment opportunities it promotes for the Kingdom as it's recognized and a financial center, which is a result of the wise leadership's successful financial policies. He expressed his hope that the private sector takes charge of development project initiatives, create job opportunities and raise its contribution to the growth rates, wishing the investors and participants all success.
Thank you. The Invest in Bahrain Forum and Exhibition is one of the most prestigious and significant events on the annual commercial calendar, attracting investors from around the region and beyond. Now in its 11th year, the 2016 edition has attracted the most attendees to date, in part due to recent regulatory reforms, which have opened up a number of industries, in a bid to enhance private sector contributions to national economic development.
We're very honored and privileged to have the 11th conference under the patronage of His Royal Highness the Prime Minister. We were very honored to have his personal presence with us this morning in launching the 11th edition of Invest in Bahrain. We aim through this conference to highlight the investment opportunities in Bahrain, whether it's on a sector basis or a specific project basis. We also use this event as a platform to showcase starting businesses in Bahrain and what Bahrain has to offer, and we use it as a springboard to promote small and medium enterprises to exhibit their products. It's been a successful event. It is this year we've experienced the highest attendance, and we look forward to growing the event further in the following years.
Bahrain's rapidly developing transport and communications infrastructure, expanding manufacturing capabilities, and special investment and logistics clusters, such as Bahrain International Investment Park, Bahrain Investment Wharf, and Bahrain Logistics Zone, are key drivers for the continuing growth of the non-oil economy. In addition to such general pull factors, investors have also been attracted to invest in Bahrain by specific opportunities, including downstream aluminium manufacturing activities, the manufacturing of fast-moving components for the GCC railway network, and various e-commerce prospects.
Today we are proud to see all these products, Bahraini products, made in Bahrain. It's really impressive that we see real good and high quality of products, including building material, which GCC countries, they need, as you know. And I have been attending this exhibition and this forum for many years now, and we thank the Ministry of Commerce, Industry and Tourism who has invited us every year.
There are a wealth of opportunities on display at Invest in Bahrain 2016, particularly in the key sectors of financial services, manufacturing, ICT, tourism and logistics, making for a very promising display this year. Reporting for Bahrain Television, I'm Danielle DePorto.
Under the patronage of Her Royal Highness, wife of His Majesty the King and President of the Supreme Council for Women, Sheikha Zabika bint Ibrahim Al Khalifa, the third National Conference for Bahraini Women held a session today that discussed legal services and their role in creating equal opportunities for women. The session, which was managed by the Chairman of the Legislation and Legal Opinion Authority, Councillor Abdullah bin Hassan Al Bahrainin, discussed four papers. The conference sessions held under the theme Women and Law, March and Achievements, Challenges and Aspirations resulted in a number of recommendations, including speeding up issuing decisions and executive regulations regarding women and families, and activating the role of the Representatives Council and civil society institutions regarding this matter, as well as reinforcing women's role in the private sector. The session stressed the importance of the presence of civil society institutions at the Representatives and Shura Council's discussion sessions regarding women legislation. It also highlighted applying the standards of SCW in the private sector in order to promote the principle of equality opportunities for women, noting that these standards are international. Foreign Affairs Minister Sheikh Khalid bin Ahmed Al Khalifa received a delegation from the American Jewish Committee, the AJC, headed by the Director of AJC's Office of Government and International Affairs, Jason Isaacson, on the occasion of the delegation's visit to the Kingdom of Bahrain. The minister reviewed with the delegation means of bolstering the historic and outstanding ties between the Kingdom of Bahrain and the U.S. in all fields for the benefit of the two countries and their people. Sheikh Khalid bin Ahmed praised the important role of the
the U.S. in promoting security and peace at the regional and international levels, affirming the support and solidarity of the kingdom to all efforts aimed at maintaining peace across the world and combating threats facing the international community. The delegation praised the friendly ties between the two countries, as well as the freedoms and openness in the kingdom, which it said reflect the spirit of civilized tolerance and coexistence across the Bahraini community. Minister of Foreign Affairs Sheikh Khalid bin Ahmed Al Khalifa received today a delegation from the European Parliament currently on a visit to the Kingdom of Bahrain. He welcomed the European Parliament delegation and expressed appreciation and pride of the distinguished historical ties between the Kingdom of Bahrain and the European Union, with the European countries, which are in continued growth and progress at all levels. The minister hailed such visits as they play a constructive role in strengthening and expanding relations between the two sides, enhancing common interests and promoting coordination frameworks on all regional and international issues. The European Parliament delegation expressed their pleasure in meeting the foreign minister and their keenness on repeating visits to the Kingdom of Bahrain in order to explore further horizons of joint cooperation for the benefit of both countries. They also lauded Bahrain's contribution in consolidating regional peace and security and its development and progress efforts, wishing it further progress and prosperity. The Minister of Justice, Islamic Affairs and Endowment, Sheikh Khalid bin Ali Al Khalifa, met today a delegation from the European Parliament, headed by a Foreign Affairs Committee member, Amjad Bashir, currently on a visit to the Kingdom. The Minister of Justice hailed the relations between Bahrain and the European countries and their development in various fields, noting the importance of such visits for enhancing cooperation, exchanging expertise and achieving mutual interest. During the meeting, scopes of cooperation and mutual interest were reviewed. The President of the Supreme Council of Health, Dr. Sheikh Mohammed bin Abdullah Al Khalifa, held a high-level government meeting today in the presence of the Minister of Information Affairs, Ali bin Mohammed Ali Al-Rumihi, as part of the Council's efforts to brief different entities on the National Health Plan 2015 to 2026. The National Health Plan, which was endorsed by the Cabinet, aims to achieve excellence in healthcare through improving quality of services, building capacities and expertise, and promoting an autonomous structure.
Actually, the cabinet orders actually very important for the government actually to improve the situation, the health situation in Bahrain, and to provide a high quality kind of service to Bahrain, and actually all comprehensive kind of system. We are actually now developing our system, physically by building a project like King Hamad, which is the oncology side, and the cardiac center, and that's actually going to make a lot of progress regarding this kind of activities. But I think that's actually part of the whole strategy of Bahrain, to improve the situation and health side, quality, cost, and that's actually the idea of moving to the social insurance system, which is going to look into all these details of quality.
And the field follow-up on Arabian Gulf Security 1 exercises indicates that the joint security exercise is moving in the right path and in accordance to the set plan. Such indications are seen during the various exercise stations, including the Command and Control Center, which is considered one of the most crucial parts of the training program. The center is equipped with the latest technologies that contribute in integrating the field exercise and in accordance to high command and guidance. In this station, orders and guidance are issued by the commanders to the security team to enter the field and implement the necessary actions as well as existing strategy. Such commands are issued through a well-organized plan that ensures that missions are accomplished without distraction to the process. During the exercises that are held within the training site, orders are given in a way that reflects the standard of compatibility that would safeguard the security of the GCC countries, their assets and achievements.